to the online classes. How are you all? Hope you all are keeping fine. Today I am going to take the fourth poem, How to Tell Wild Animals by Carolyn Wells. The poem How to Tell Wild Animals by Carolyn Wells revolves around the dangerous ways to identify the wild animals. The poet tries to distinguish one animal from the other in a humorous way. The poet suggests that it is very risky to be in such a close proximity to these wild beasts. The poem is thus very educative as it tells us about various features of wild animals. Now I will read the stanzas one by one and then explain the stanzas to you. The first stanza: if ever you should go by chance, and if there should to you advance, if he roars at you as you are dying, to jungles in the east, a large and tawny beast, you will The poet here cautions the readers against the wild beast found in the jungle. He says that if by chance you happen to go to any forest in the east, you are likely to encounter a brownish yellow in color. And if that beast roars loudly at you and you feel that you are going to die due to fear, then you will come to know that it is the Asian lion. The second stanza: or if sometime when roaming round with black strips on a yellow ground, the simple rule may help you learn, a noble wild beast greets you, just notice if he eats you, the Bengal tiger to discern. Explanation: the poet says that it is very likely that while roaming in the forest, you are greeted by a wild beast. This wild animal is very impressive in size, and his majestic body is covered with black strips on a yellow hide. The poet cautions that if the readers notice this beast, and that if he eats them, then this simple rule people are able to understand this. Now the third stanza: if strolling forth a beast you view, whose hide with spots is peppered, as soon as he has leapt on you, you will know it is the leopard. It will do no good to roar with pain. He will only leap and leap again. The explanation: the poet here helps the readers to identify a leopard. He says that if you happen to walk in the forest, you might encounter a beast with spots on his skin. When this wild beast will jump at you, you will understand that it is a leopard, as he will keep jumping on you and will tear you apart. Moreover, it will be of no use then to shout or cry with pain, because he will continue pouncing on you. So be careful and don't allow it to leap on you. Now, the next stanza. If, when you are walking round your yard, you meet a creature there who hugs you very, very hard, be sure it is a bear. If you have any doubts, I guess he will give you just one more caress. The explanation. The poet says that while you are walking in your yard, you may encounter a creature there. When this creature hugs you very, very tightly, then believe that it is a bear. Bears are thought to be good wrestlers and can give a really tight hug, although a friendly hug is referred to as bear hug. If a real bear hugs you, then it may not feel friendly at all. The bear hugs a man to kill him. The poet further says that in case of any doubt, you will find that the bear will embrace you once again till death. The fifth stanza. Though to the crocodile you always may tell from the hyena thus. Hyenas come with merry smiles, but if they weep, they are crocodiles. The explanation. The poet here says that a novice, a beginner, may be puzzled and confused, and thus might not be able to distinguish between the different wild animals. Hence, the poet helps to differentiate the crocodiles from the hyena. He says that a hyena always laughs as it swallows its victim. A laughing hyena's voice resembles humans' laughing sound. A crocodile, on the other hand, is said to shed tears while eating its prey. The poet thus warns the readers to not wait for a hyena to laugh or for a crocodile to weep. The last stanza of the poem. The true chameleon is small, a lizard sort of things. He hasn't any ears at all, and not a single wing. If there is nothing on the tree, it is the chameleon you see. The explanation. The poet describes a chameleon in this stanza. He says, further says that if you are unable to see a thing on the tree, then chances are that a chameleon is still there. A chameleon is an expert at camouflage. It changes color as per its surroundings and is therefore difficult to see. This capacity of camouflage helps the lizard in saving it from hunters. Hope, students, you liked the poem, understood the poem. Go through the poem once again by yourself and try to summarize the poem by yourself. Have a nice day. God bless.